So even though Donald Trump lost at the Supreme Court last week because the SCOTUS would not take up the Texas AG's case, you did still have 106 members of the House of Representatives sign on to that particular lawsuit. And yes, ladies and gentlemen, that is an act of sedition. Now, sedition is defined as any act or speech designed to incite rebellion against the government. Well, the government made a decision to hold elections a certain way. The public voted. Those election results were certified, and these Republicans came in and said, no, 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 we want it all overturned. So you could easily argue that is an act of sedition. And these are members of Congress. They know the law. They're supposed to. At least one person in Congress does know the law. That would be Representative Bill Pascrell. Because on Friday, Bill Pascrell sent a letter to Nancy Pelosi and Zoe Loughlin telling them that, hey, you need to punish these 106 Republicans who engaged in these acts of sedition. And in his memo, Pascoe points out, you literally have the constitutional authority to do this. And as he said, I think you need to do it to teach these people a lesson. Here is what it is. It's Article 1, Section 5 of the United States Constitution that says, quote, no person shall be a senator or representative in Congress or elector of the president and vice president or hold any office, civil or military, under the United States or under any state who, having previously taken an oath as a member of Congress or as an officer of the United States or as a member of any state legislature, or as an executive or judicial officer in any state to support the Constitution of the United States shall have engaged in insurrection or rebellion against the same or given aid or comfort to the enemies thereof. But Congress may, by a vote of 2/3 of each house, remove such disability. I don't disagree with that classification of Republican members of the House of Representatives. At this point, for the United States, they are in fact a disability. They openly signed on to a lawsuit to overturn the results of the 2020 election, not because they actually thought there was fraud, but because their guy didn't win. This isn't just, I'm going to take my ball and go home. This is, I'm going to take your country away from you if you don't give me what I want. That is an act of sedition. That is absolutely punishable. The question is, does Nancy Pelosi have the spine to bring this to the attention of the public? She has to. I know she doesn't, and I know she won't. Don't think for a second that I have any faith in Nancy Pelosi to ever do the right thing. But she should, and it's issues like this where she is most, I guess you would say, incompetent. This is one of those things where, sure, maybe it is a symbolic vote, but this is the kind of thing that the public needs to be aware of. The public has to understand that technically, by definition, what these members of Congress did was in fact a violation of the United States Constitution, United States laws, and we are going to hold them accountable. If not remove them from office, then publicly shame them so that they forever carry that stigma with them. That is what should be done. That is what could be done. That is what the Constitution allows a remedy for. The only problem is we don't have any Democrats in the House in leadership positions who have enough backbone to actually make it a reality.